A DIY solar installation shouldn't mean it can't be safe and legal. I'll walk you through the steps to register your DIY solar installation in the UK. I'll share the details on how to source some of the information needed to complete this task. Any energy generation equipment connected to the national grid in the UK must be registered with your local distribution network operator, or DNO for short. The DNO is a company that manages electricity distribution in your area. When registering your solar installation with the DNO, the process will depend on the size of your system, and there are two main forms to that regard. G98 form is for systems with an inverter of a size up to 3.68 kilowatts, and G99 form is for anything larger than that. Okay, let's focus on the G98 form, since that's the most common home installation. The form requires straightforward details about the system owner, the address installation, but there are two pieces of information that aren't obvious and may take a bit of effort to source. The MPAN, or the meter point administration number. This is a unique number that identifies the electricity meter at your home. You can find that number on your electricity bill, or the easiest way to do that is simply Google "What's my MPAN?" and go to the National Grid website. The next key information is the ENA device reference number. This is a device number that links back to the type test register of the ENA, which is Energy Network Association. This number references an entry in the database of ENA, which states whether this device has been tested by the ENA and whether it's compliant or not. It is very important to pick a device which is compliant, and this will guarantee that your process for G98 submission will go smoothly. You can find this number by visiting the type test register website of the ENA. On that website, you'd be able to search by the manufacturer of your device, by the size of your inverter, and a few other filtering categories that will help you narrow down and pinpoint the exact device that you're installing. Okay, now that we've got these two crucial pieces of information, we can fill it in into the G98 form. Here's an example of how you can do that. An important step here is to submit that form by emailing it to the National Grid within 28 days of commissioning your system. The submission process is usually done by emailing the G98 filled-in form alongside a schematic diagram. The schematic diagram describes how the inverter is placed in your installation, where the DNO cutoff is, where is your consumer unit, and if there are any isolators and cutoff points that need to be specified. You will also need to specify your name and address on that schematic diagram.